Actually, we decided to move to the Lake Country area in 1985 and decided to build a new home. So while the home was under construction, we spent time several Sundays here looking at different churches, although that search was fairly limited because we knew we wanted to do a Missouri Synod Lutheran church. So we went to DR and went there multiple times, and quite frankly didn't do any other research because we were happy with what we found at DR. And so I think it was early 1986 that we decided to join. We grew in our faith significantly over those years. And it's been a combination of the pastors, the church staff, obviously all the members, the school, and we just felt we kept growing. And probably the single most influential thing was the men's Bible study for me. It's been almost 20 years, and I've grown my faith significantly as a result of that men's Bible study. One of the really missing pieces in the stewardship grouping was an endowment fund. Was people looking, if you look at biblical stewardship, it's not only today, it's tomorrow. And if you realize that everything we have has been given to us by the Lord, when we leave this earth, shouldn't we be giving some of that back to continue the mission of the church? Legacy to me is a very important word, and I did a little research on just looking up definitions, and I'm going to use a little cheat sheet here. But so legacy is something that's passed on, usually after departing this world. And that can be a number of different things in a legacy. It can be a legacy of your faith. It can be your core values. It can be monetary or financial. But I think the part of the definition that I like most is it's using the life you lead as an example to others to guide their futures. The legacy circle is set up so that this is really just an indication of your intent to include Divine Redeemer in the endowment fund in your long-term financial planning. So this is not a legally binding commitment. This is not, we don't ask for any dollar amounts or types of gifts. This is simply sign a letter indicating that we have decided to include Divine Redeemer in our long-term financial planning. But it still boils down to, as a Christian, wanting to give back to do the Lord's work. And what better way than to use some of your financial assets that you've accumulated over time to go in a special fund that's going to do special things to maintain our mission as a church. And it's a rather straightforward, painless way to carry on the mission of the church. I started this endowment fund years ago. As we look to the next 10, 15, 25, 50 years, imagine what we can do as a congregation if we continue to build up this endowment fund over time.